Good morning, my name is Sarah Harris, and we did our project, bullying. And there are four types of bullying. We have psychological bullying, verbal and nonverbal, and physical bullying. Psychological bullying is when you are using threatening looks, faces, or decisions. Verbal and nonverbal. Verbal bullying is when you are shouting at someone, calling them names, mocking them, or making racial, ethnic, or religious comments. Nonverbal bullying is done through the internet or on the phone. When it's done on the internet, it's also known as cyberbullying. Okay, I have a question for you all. How do you think bullying gets started?
If somebody talks to you in this
discussion. Okay, well that's one way. But bullying can get started in a child as young as the age of 6 years old. It happens, like, it depends on their environment, their surroundings. It's like what you experience as a child would lead on to if you're gonna get a bully when you get older or not. Okay, also, do you think going to get help always resolves bullying? Do you think always going to get help resolves bullying? Well, in some cases it don't, especially in elementary school students, because some teachers respond to it as it being a part of a children's normal behavior. So getting help always doesn't help. And have y'all seen bullying happen in y'all high school? Have y'all ever noticed bullying around? That was just a general question. I've never seen it happen in my high school. So I was just asking that. I have a couple facts. Okay, more than 160,000 U.S. students stay home from school each day from the fear of being bullied. 8% of students miss one day of class per month from fear of bullies. And from playground statistics, every 7 minutes a child is being bullied. 77% of students are bullied mentally, verbally, and physically. Bullying is the most common form of violence. Between 15% and 30% of students are bullied or victims of bullies. Direct physical bullying increases in elementary school, it peaks in middle school, and declines in high school. But on the other hand, but verbal abuse remains constant. The 43% fear harassment in the bathroom at school. 282,000 students are physically attacked in secondary schools each month, which is really another name for high school in other countries. One out of five kids admit to being bullied or doing some bullying. 22% of students know someone who has been bullied online, and 19% of students admit to saying something hurtful to others online. Over 14% of high school students have considered suicide, and almost 7% have attempted suicide. About 35% of kids have been threatened online, and a poll of teens from ages 12 to 17 proved that they think violence increased at their schools.
Girls use emotional violence. They do things to deliberately make others feel alienated and alone, like using prank calls, cyberbullying, encouraging other children to harass or pick on a victim, like playing like deliberately hostile games or jokes on a person. Boys, they tend to bully using more physical violence, and boys are usually bullied both psychologically and physically. Often, girls though, when they're bullied, they're at a higher risk for suicide though. And boys, when they bully, they're more likely to hit, slap, punch, gang up on, and spit on their victims. And the physical violence that happens in boys, it happens in all ethnic groups, and it happens in all age levels. And people are usually more receptive of boys who are bullied. They see, boys are going to do that kind of thing, or they're just being bullied. But it's really not okay, and if people were given, if it was like treated as more of a consequence, it could really, help stop bullying. Also, one of the biggest ways to recognize bullying is to maintain open communication with your child, or maintain open communication with your sibling or your friend. One of the biggest reasons to recognize, it's really important to recognize bullying because not everybody says they're getting bullied, and they may feel ashamed or embarrassed to say that they're getting bullied. So you should always check your child's social media websites, their Twitter, their Facebook, to make sure nothing's happening. Also, if their child suddenly seems afraid to go to like certain school-related places, like bus stops, bathrooms, or other places, that's a really good indicator that a child may be getting bullied. Also, if they suddenly seem to have like no friends, or they're suddenly afraid of social-related activities, that's a huge sign that a child could be getting bullied. Also, recognize a child's lack of interest or activities they once enjoyed. If they once enjoyed going to school, if they once enjoyed extracurricular activities, and suddenly they don't really seem to want to do those things anymore, they don't really want to leave the house anymore, that could be a huge sign that a child is getting bullied. Also, notice drastic changes in their mood. If they're really moody, really irritable, more likely to get depressed, if they're having, they're sleeping too much, if they're not getting enough sleep, that's another, or if they're having nightmares, that's another huge sign that a child could be getting bullied. Also, trouble concentrating, school refusal, declining grades, eating changes, and sudden loss of friends are also ways that you can notice that a child is getting bullied. If they have like ripped and torn clothing, or it appears like their personal belongings have damaged, that's another key sign that a child could be getting bullied. And we could all help to stop bullying if it was taken more seriously as a consequence. A lot of times bullying stops when people intervene on behalf of the victim.
Good morning, my name is Ashley Talmadge, and my topic was the most common places where bullying happens. Bullying happens with school, in schools, bullying happens at school, with school-aged children. Most of the time it's physical bullying, which includes physical contact that will hurt or injure a person by hitting, kicking, or punching. Another type of bullying that happens in schools is verbal bullying, which could be name-calling, making offensive remarks, or joking about a person's religion, gender, ethnicity, socioeconomic status, or the way they look. There also can be indirect bullying, which includes spreading rumors or stories about someone, or telling others about something that you were told in private. Another form of bullying in schools is social alienation. It's when a bully excludes someone from a group on purpose. And it also includes bullying, spreading rumors, and also making fun of someone by pointing out their differences. Intimidation is the last one, and it's when a bully threatens someone else and frightens that person to make him or her do what they want them to do. There's also bullying in the workplace as far as with teenagers and with adults. And the definition of bullying in the workplace is the repeated less favorable treatment of a person by another or others in the workplace. Bullying in the workplace can range from very obvious verbal or physical assault to very subtle psychological abuse. This behavior could include physical or verbal abuse, yelling or screaming, or using offensive language in the workplace as well as outside the workplace with coworkers, excluding or isolating employees, physiological harassment, intimidation, assigning meaningless tasks unrelated to the job, giving employees impossible jobs, deliberately changing work rosters to inconvenience particular employees, or to convenience hiring employees, undermining work performance by deliberately withholding information vital to effective work performance, and bullying that most people do not know is bullying among the elderly. According to the Department of Health and Science Services Administration on Aging, 2010 alone, there were 2,700 complaints of elderly resident-to-resident bullying. Most people know that people that work with the elderly could bully the elderly by harassing them, whether it's physical or verbally, but most people don't know that bullying happens from resident to resident among the elderly. It can range anywhere from not allowing a person to sit at a particular table during mealtimes or barring them from participating in public activity are two common forms of bullying seen among elders in an institutional setting. Bullying can also be based on gender differences. Men tend to adopt a more direct style, preferring to verbally abuse someone to their face as far as between the elderly, or sometimes take a physical approach to their bullying. Women, on the other hand, of course, the elderly, engage in more behind-the-back or passive-aggressive abuse style. So as we can see, bullying in high schools, bullying in the workplace, and bullying among the elderly, that's three different age ranges as far as bullying happens. So bullying can happen to anyone.
Hey, my name is
Salisha Hick.
I'll be closing this topic of bullying with a question. Have anyone of y'all been bullied before? How did you stop bullying?
I bullied them back.
Well, of course, me, myself, I got to fight with the person. But there's other ways you can stop bullying. You can stop by talking to a friend or telling your parents, sometimes telling them you're not going to even help it because that person will just don't, they'll tell you in a minute, just do what you got to do. And that person will, like, or you can become a friend that's bullying yourself. Like, maybe ask them questions why they don't like you. Ask them what's their problem. It's many ways it would be crazy because they'll say, oh, I don't like you because you're doing this or oh, a boyfriend or something like that. And they'll just bully you with some stuff. But there's a lot of ways that you can do it besides fighting or just doing the crazy stuff. You can also tell teachers, sometimes that's not helping. But you think bullying is still going on?
Yeah.
Where do you think it's going on?
Everywhere. The grocery store?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. The grocery store, it's people kind of thinking online. People are running against stuff. Like, pushing people.
Yeah. A lot of bullying also can form into gangs, too. I haven't noticed that. Like, a lot of people have been bullied to, like, the gangs or whatever.
Yeah.
It's really crazy how you, like, want to read up on that. I have did that plenty of times. Bullying is—it really happens to little kids or middle school, high school. You really don't see it like that because people get older and get mature. In college, I barely see it now. I'm surprised that we have had fights and stuff, but it's really, to me, it's like really childish. So just don't bully anybody.
What about
cyber?
Do you think it's different methods of bullying now? What about cyber bullying?
Yes, I didn't believe this too.
There's times that I ignore bullying. Like, what is that?
Cyberbullying. It's like the use of the internet, like email, social media websites, like Twitter, Facebook, and internet websites to deliberately hostile messages to attack their victims. This one is like, it's particularly more dangerous because people are more bold online. They probably say it with even more cruelty than they would in person.
Because they put fake pictures.
Yeah, and they can reach you from like anywhere. That person has your cell phone, they have their email, they can just deliberately send you hostile messages all the time. And that's why this one is particularly dangerous, and I think that's a big reason why it's been an increase in bullying-related suicides from like 2010, like from to the present now.
So what do you think is the most common form of bullying?
I would say cyberbullying, especially on like Facebook and Twitter, that people are just going back and forth. But some
think about the fact that when you're fussing on Facebook and Twitter, if that person that you're fussing with print out that page and take it to the police department, you can get a charge for it. So I think cyberbullying is probably the most common form.
And among adults, like in the workplace or in the elderly, verbal and physical bullying is more common among adults. Cyberbullying is more like teenagers or middle school age kids.